Is this Allsky lens worth to buy, or is it worth to upgrade this ZWO default lens to this one? Let's check it out in this video. This position is to adjust the distance, the middle one to adjust the focus, and the last one is to adjust the aperture. This top screw I use at infinite, and the aperture, usually I use it the widest one. It will be bright. Then you adjust the focus as you want. The default Allsky lens that comes with a ZWO 224 has 150 degrees. This one has only 100. Usually people search for 180, so they can fit all the sky in a little bubble, a circle. But what I was looking for was a smaller, in order to make zoom. It's like using a Barlow in an eyepiece. You get a bit more of zoom, but less field of view of the sky. This benefit meteor showers, where you can see better the meteors, but in a smaller field of view. So if you want a large field of view, you will search for a 180. If you want a bit more of magnification, you will want this lens or similar. Also, you can see this one is taller, but it will fit anyway in the adapter that comes with the ZWO. Another advantage this lens has comparing to the default ZWO lens, this is IR corrected, so you don't need any filter on this. It makes the correction. So that means that we'll rectify the visible light and the infrared light in the same plane and get rid of the infrared aberrations. Having so small screws, it's very hard to focus. So when you catch the focus, then you will tighten the screw and it will lose a bit. While in this one, the default one, you just turn around, and then when you tighten the little screw to lock, it will stay at the same place. This one, no. So something to consider in this kind of lenses. Another great advantage is in the field. If you have buildings around or trees, tall trees, with this lens you can go deeper in the sky, just only in that field of view. So you get rid of all that mess that you have around. Now let's check how this performs against the default Allsky lens. This is a regular time lapse with a new lens, and I have other videos where I show how to do this. Let's compare four different images. The new lens has a slightly better quality, mainly because of the infrared correction. We can clearly see that by the color differences. By the way, don't forget to give a like to the video. Just focus on the field of view size. And while the default lens has only one field of view to use, the new lens has the advantage to allow you to adjust the zoom in order to get different fields of view. Comparing the top left image, the default ZWO lens with 150 degrees field of view, with the top right image, the new lens with 100 degree field of view, we can see already a difference, but not very pronounced. However, when we start zooming the new lens, of course, we start to see the differences. Zooming the new lens more or less until the middle, we can see in the bottom left image a larger magnification. And then at the bottom right, using the lens at maximum magnification, this is what we get. At the end, I use almost all the time the new lens because of its flexibility. That, in conjunction with an inexpensive price it has, makes this lens a good upgrade. For the ones that are watching this video in a small screen,
I will now show the four images one at a time.
And of course, if you like Allsky, you may want to click on this video right here to check other interesting things that I do with Allsky Lens.